欢迎大家。
Welcome to today's press briefing. On the stage, we have Dr. Albert Au, Principal Medical and Health Officer, Communicable Disease Branch of Center for Health Protection, and Dr. Lau Kahin, Chief Manager of Hospital Authority. The two doctors will provide an update on COVID cases and NHA situation. Dr. Au, good afternoon, Hong Kong citizens, friends from the media. I'd like to report the COVID situation as of the 28th of June.As of yesterday, we recorded 1,849 local infections, including 788 PCR positive cases, as well as 1,061 RAT positive results confirmed via PCR. We also recorded 155 new imported cases yesterday, including 116 PCR positive cases and 39 RAT positive cases. Cumulatively, since the start of the fifth wave, we have logged 1.238028 million cases. We did not report any death cases as of yesterday. So far, the death count remains at 1,186 cases. Dr. Lau will give you an update on HA situation. At the moment, we have 671 confirmed cases in our facilities, with 107 of them being new cases. For those requiring isolation facilities, 224 are now in isolation wards, 19 in second tier wards, and 207 patients receiving treatment at North Lantau Hospital Hong Kong Infection Control Center.Among them, 91 are new cases. Yesterday, we reported one more patient in critical condition and one in serious condition. For inpatients, there are 13 in critical condition and 14 in serious conditions. And three in critical condition are receiving intensive care treatment. We did not log any death case yesterday. I'll give the floor to Dr. Au.We have 155 imported cases logged yesterday. 65 of them were picked up at the TPCC at the airport, and 63 cases were picked up in quarantine hotels, and 27 remaining cases picked up after the completion of the quarantine period. Yesterday, three more residential care homes reported new cases, including one RCHD and two RCHEs. The first one is in Sha Tin.新生精神康復會博康宿舍. In this residential care home, two residents tested positive, respectively on the 27th and 28th. They started to exhibit symptoms. Both have been triple jabbed. And on the 28th of June, they tested RAT positive. They live on the same floor. And they both work in a sheltered workshop in Nam Chong. And 11 residents sharing the same room are deemed close contact. They will be sent to quarantine. The second is Sage Dong Lin Bok Yun, Wu Ling An Lo Yun in Sai Kung. And a staff member has tested positive. She started to exhibit symptoms on the 27th of June, and she tested RAT positive on the 28th, which was also the last day she attended work. She also received three jabs, and two colleagues, four residents in this home are deemed close contacts, and they would need to be sent to quarantine. The third one is Sage Guan Chun, Wu Lei An Lo Yun in Southern District. One care worker and one resident have tested positive.This care worker received three jabs, and he tested positive on the 25th of June, and he last worked on the 24th. On the third floor where he worked, on the 28th of June, one resident tested PCR positive. And on the same day, he started to exhibit symptoms. He was sent to hospital. He had three jabs, and seven close contacts have been identified. For schools, this morning, we all together received 217 positive reports involving 186 schools, including 36 kindergartens, come childcare centers, and 19 primary schools, 59 secondary schools, and two special schools. And we also logged 87 schools reporting more than 2 cases in the past 7 days. Now there are clusters in individual classes in some schools, and we have recommended classes mentioned, including Tin Shui Wai Government School Class 4C. 31 students in the class and 4 cases have been identified. The second one is Holy Mother Kindergarten Catholic Church in the upper class Sun, and then the whole day upper class Ngoi. There are 32 students for the morning class. We identified 3 cases. Chan Bat Wan Gei Lim Yau Zi Yun of Trinity Church. And in the PM class, among the 8 students, we found 2 cases. The Public Health Laboratory Service yesterday recorded 25 BA.2.12.1 cases, including those linked cases, and 13 untraceable cases. And there are also 10 cases being the close contacts of family members of the 13 untraceable cases. The addresses are as follows: City 1, Block 19 of Sha Tin, 2 cases in the same household, and a colleague of one of these cases also test positive. Lam Chun Chak Ho of Sa Kok Mei. There is another case sharing a meal with the infected case, also testing positive. And then the next case, Block A, Hang Wai Gong Yip Chung Sam in Chun Mun. And then Blocks Mei Leung House, Shakip Mei. There are 4 cases in this household. And Yok Ming Yun, Block C, Hei Ming House in Chang Kwan O, with 2 cases in the household. And Chun Wan Riviera Garden, Hoi Kun Gok, Block 9, Yu Chau Street, number 5, Mong Kok, Siu Hei Yun, Ah Hei House, Lai Chi Kok Road, 338 Yat Chi House of Tun Yat Estate, and also Happy Valley, Broadwood Road, Broadwood Terrace, 2 cases in the same household. And Shun Lei Estate, Lei Ming House, 2 cases in the same household. Finally, in Wangpo Garden, Gan Pa Yun, Block 4. We've also recorded 2 cases with epidemiological connection with previous cases. Yesterday, we announced a case living in Ma Tin Chun, Yun Long, and the colleague of this case also tested positive. Next case, relating to Block P of Cornhill, and in the same floor, we have identified another case. As for BA.4.5, we recorded 15 suspected cases. 3 are imported cases. 4 are untraceable cases. 4 other cases are connected to the 4 cases. They are the family members. The first one is a 41-year-old case, who is the supervisor of the housekeeping section of L'Hotel Causeway Bay. He lives in Oi Tai House of Fu Tai Estate, Tuen Mun, on the 26th of June. The specimen result was indeterminate, so the result was sent to the Public Health Laboratory Service. Finally, the specimen tested positive with the subvariant BA.4 or 0.5. On the 27th of June, the same case tested negative. As the case works in the hotel, he belongs to the regular testing group, and on the 15th and 19th of June, the test results were both negative. We suspect that this case has been infected as a result of contact with the visitors in the restaurant. There are 3 other untraceable cases, including one living in Red Hill Peninsula, Block 5, 1 Yuen Long Castle Peak Row, 10 May Park Yo Ho, 25A. There are 5 members testing positive in the same household, and also one in Shunling Row, 439 Shunling Goi. 4 more cases with epidemiological link with previous cases, one in Gam Yi House, Gam Ying Court, the family member, and one another, the family member of an estate in Hong Ham, and the other is a family member of Harbour Plaza Resort City in Tin Shui Wai. the last one, Chi Lok House in Chi Jing Estate, who is a colleague of another infected case. He works in the Poland Kok Chau Hong Piu Daycare Center for the Elderly. We have asked all staff members to be tested. He tested, yes, negative on the 27th. He works in the kitchen, and other kitchen workers are regarded as close contact and they'll be tested.
For the past 24 hours, 80 patients have recovered, including 65 patients discharged. For the fifth wave, there are about 51,853 patients recovered, about 51,497 patients discharged. And since early 2022, Hong Kong has 64,233 patients, of which 603,877 discharged, and two patients have been detected in admission screening and in hospital testing, and three patients in the same ward are classified as close contacts. For our staff, currently we have 24,298 staff infected, but 24,012 of those returned to their workplaces. And an incident on the TKL Hospital Internal Medicine Ward. At the TKL Hospital and the Internal Medicine Ward, an 88-year-old female patient on 27th of June and through admission screening tested positive for COVID. The infection control team immediately conducted contact tracing. As this patient during the incubation period has visited or stayed in the internal medicine ward, after testing and found that in the same ward, there were two other female patients tested positive. And in the same cubicle, and two other patients were classified as close contacts and need to undergo quarantine. The three confirmed cases, including the one admitted on 27th and the two case tested positive, are currently undergoing quarantine and treatment and in stable condition. And the hospital has tested the staff working at the ward, and they so far they all tested negative, and also collect environmental samples, and they all turn out negative. And the ward has stopped accepting new cases and the visitation arrangements and conducted thorough cleansing and disinfection. The hospital will continue to monitor the staff and the patient's health and will work with the CHP to follow up on the latest situation. And there's the latest update on the contingency plan in public hospitals. Currently, we have over 600 confirmed cases staying in public hospitals. And most of these patients are in a minor condition, with a small number of which fall into the serious or critical category. Even though we see a rise in admitted cases, the public hospitals are still able to cope and has not put a lot of pressure onto our hospitals. We have sufficient supply of isolation beds, and hope that we can still maintain beds waiting for patients and able to admit patients immediately. The HA has not let down its guard and prepared for a rebound. Recently, the HA has formed a high-level emergency response command center, which greatly enhances its emergency capacity to monitor the epidemic development. The command center will make up cluster management with a command and coordination and execution capabilities, and can swiftly respond to any emergencies. If we see a further surge, we have made up a beds mobilization plan, and we can mobilize thousands of beds for patients at once. And anytime we have several hundreds of beds ready for COVID patients. If necessary, within 48 hours, we can deploy over 10% of ER and rehabilitation beds, total 2,000, to receive COVID patients. Within 1 week, we can mobilize 25% of the beds, about 5,000 of those to receive COVID patients. In 2 weeks, we can deploy a half of the total number of beds, about 11,500 for COVID patients. Besides hospital beds, at North Lantau Hospital Infection Control Center, we have 800 beds, and Asia World Expo 900 beds that are standing ready for COVID patients. That's all today. As now, open the floor for questions, and please state the media represents. TVB News, two questions. It's been reported that there might be a national leader visiting Hong Kong. How do you assess Hong Kong's current COVID situation? Of the Hong Kong 18 districts, and is Tuen Mun being hit the hardest for Wan Chai and others? Do you have the relevant data or assessment? Thank you for your question. First, on the COVID situation, for the past week, we noticed there has been a rise in caseload and at a rather high level. It's been noticed from early June. And this week, and for every day, we have about 1,500 or close to 2,000 cases like today. This demonstrated there has been some transmission chain in the community. And this may be due to the relaxing of social distancing measures in late May, and while things are getting back to normal, and which means more social activities, and with a restaurant opening for longer, and this will give rise to more cases in the community. We see that the daily caseload is rising steadily instead of a spike. And looking at the admission data, that most cases are minor or asymptomatic cases. Those serious or those need to be admitted to hospital or even mortality cases at currently is still at a very stable level. And for the district by district situation, for each district, we notice there's been a rise across the board. While some district may have more caseload than others, for example, in Central or Western District, we'll be monitoring the districts. So far, we can't tell whether one district has a more noticeable spike. We see that it's a territory-wide increase. Next question. Orange News. Well, now we have more asymptomatic 0.4, 0.5 cases. For these two variants, do you think they has taken root in the community? Is it currently hard to detect the transmission chain of these two variants? Just now, talk about the Casper Bay Nina Hotel and the housekeeping supervisor. During a shift, has she been wearing protective gown? And which floor that she mainly worked on? Just now, you said that maybe she has been exposed to quarantine guests and infected. What kind of exposure was she subject to? According to Hong Kong U, that the peak will come in early July. What's the CHP take on the Hong Kong U projection? And today we have over 2,000 cases in total. Would you see that July being the peak?
Thank you for your question. First, about BA.4.5, starting this week, we have begun to detect more cases belonging to BA.4.5. These are untraceable cases. Previously, we also picked up some similar cases, but after investigation, we found that they might be related to imported cases. For example, those working at the airport or the quarantine hotels. And previously, there was also a case involving a driver taking arrivals to designated hotels and the related family members. But starting this week, after investigation, we have found some other cases not related to imported cases. And the number under this category in the past 2 days have has risen, and we have found so far 10 untraceable cases. Now we are concerned about these cases because by being untraceable, it means that they could have been infected in the local community, and this means there might be silent transmission chains in the community belonging to BA.4.5. Perhaps the transmission has taken place during social activities. The Public Health Laboratory Service would conduct gene sequencing analysis for all cases, and if it's L452R, it could be BA.4.5. And at the moment, we would send these cases to quarantine or isolation, and the family members would be subject to quarantine as well, and also compulsory testing notices were issued against high-risk places. BA.4.5 now constitute only a small percentage of infected cases. On the contrary, most cases, most positive cases belong to BA.2.12.1 or BA.2.2. So we'll keep in view the situation. Second question relates to this case working in a hotel. I understand that as this case is a supervisor, he may accompany some specimen collection team members to go up to hotel rooms in order to collect specimens. So it is possible that as the team members open the hotel room doors to collect specimens from visitors, he might be around. But according to this case, he also donned PPEs, he wore a face mask, even gloves. So he was fully protected. But we are also inquiring with the hotel to see whether there have been BA.5.4 cases in the hotel. This case has a low CT value, so it may not be, we may not come to any conclusion. But after all, it is possible that this supervisor might have been infected at the workplace because of contact with visitors. I don't have comments on the Hong Kong use projection. Next question. This one in front. I'm from Hong Kong 01. Good afternoon. About Chelsea Heights, yesterday you said that you would check vaccine pass information. Do you have any update? And about the Victoria Harbour restaurant at Chelsea Heights, now have they contravened any regulation? Will they be subject to suspension, and until when? And just now, Dr. Lau said that the HA has no pressure in terms of a supply of hospital beds. Do you have any idea about when the AWE and other isolation facilities will be recommissioned? Thank you for your question. About Victoria Harbour restaurant at Chelsea Heights, we have not logged new cases. Now, previously, we retrieved information in the vaccine pass record, and we also inquired about the patrons visiting the restaurant on the 16th of June, and we have detected 42 cases. No staff have been affected, and last Thursday, through the Leave Home Safe app and through cases contact tracing of BA.2.12.1 cases, we identified this cluster, and immediately we launched an investigation with the FEHD and EMSD. We collected environmental samples, which all tested negative, and we also requested the restaurant to conduct thorough cleansing and disinfection. We also urged them to arrange for staff to get tested via PCR. The results are all negative. And the EMSD also checked the ventilation system and found that the air exchange rate is below par, and the FEHD is following up on the matter. As for hospital bed arrangement, basically, we have the HA hospital beds as well as those in the North Lantau Hospital, Hong Kong Infection Control Center. As I mentioned, within a short period of time, we seek to be able to receive many more patients, and we can commission 2,000 beds within 48 hours, and within 1 week, we can provide 5,000 more beds, and altogether 11,500 more beds in 2 weeks. And there are 800 beds at AWE in And if the caseload continues to rise, and say if we have 50% or more occupancy rate at the North Lantau Hospital facility, we will consider recommissioning the facility at AWE. Next question. I'm from Hong Kong Economic Times about Jay Garden. Has any new case been detected? And have you traced the number of patrons visiting the restaurant on the 19th? Have they conducted compulsory testing already? And also, do you know the source of infection in Chung Kwan Old Hospital medical ward? Any visitors? And about 11,500 hospital beds you mentioned, what is the occupancy rate at the moment? Now, about moving patients, does HA have a detailed plan? And there is a suggestion that for arrivals, the new quarantine arrangement is to stay in a hotel for 3 days and then 4 days of home surveillance. Does the CHP recommend them to stay in, or will they be allowed to go out? And about Nina Hotel Hospital Bay, is there any infections among those who stayed in the hotel before? Let me take the question and then I'll defer to Dr. Lau. For Jade Garden, we haven't picked up any new case today. And the relevant period is around noon on the 19th of June. Previously, according to our investigation, two cases belong to BA.2.12.1 of Victoria Harbour Restaurant Cluster. We could then launch compulsory testing and we picked up two more cases. This could be a small-scale transmission, and we have retrieved Leave Home Safe information and see whether there are other cases who also visited the restaurant at the same time. We announced on the 24th of June the compulsory testing notice. On the 25th of June, the restaurant conducted thorough cleansing and disinfection. About 70 staff members also conducted PCR tests. The results returned are all negative. Yesterday, we also visited the restaurant with AVHD and EMSD in terms of air purifiers and the ventilation as a whole. Everything is proper, and we will continue to trace and see if there are new cases who have visited the restaurant before. Preventing importation of cases is an important strategy of the government to prevent the emergence of new subvariants of the virus in Hong Kong. And the government conducts a regular review on the relevant anti-epidemic measures and this is based on the global trend, possible outbreaks, emergence of new cases, and our isolation facilities. As for Nina Hotel, investigation is still ongoing. And in the same period of time, there are positive cases, but we'll check whether these are all BA.4.5 cases. I don't have details at the moment. For the 88-year-old female patient in Chung Kwan Old Hospital, when she was readmitted on the 27th, she tested positive. In fact, whilst at home, she had tested RT positive before because her family members also tested positive while she was in hospital before, so she was readmitted to hospital again. And we conducted a round of testing for her and for the staff as well. We'll continue to conduct investigation to get more details. We'll check, for example, her CT values and the subsequent test results of the patient so that we'll have a better idea of the whole story. Now, regarding bed deployment, I can give you more figures. We have 224 patients now staying in first tier or isolation beds. We have 1,200 first tier isolation beds in supply, so that's about one-sixth occupied, and for the second tier, we have 600 hospital beds. We have 19 patients taking up these beds at the moment. As for North Lantau Hospital, Hong Kong Infection Control Center, we have 800 beds available and some 200 patients staying in. So the supply of beds should cope with our admission rate. We're talking about not many patients admitted, just a few dozens new cases every day, as we announce every day. Subject to the epidemic situation, if there is a need to receive more patients requiring us to vacate hospital beds for the purpose, we may consider suspending certain non-urgent services. As we understand, if a patient is subject to examination or operation, the patient may take up a bed space. But so far, we are able to cope. Definitely, we have arrangements ready. We have a plan. As I explained just now, within a certain period of time, certain beds will be made available. We do have this response plan. Say the number of beds will be commissioned for use within a certain period of time with all the manpower ready in the planning. And definitely, there would be adjustments of services. So we'll continue to keep in view the situation and devise a plan.
Next question. White shirt in the back row. Now news. Well, on the trend, with the C3C that we may hit the peak on July. For today's caseload has exceeded 2,000. So at what level do you expect the numbers to peak? And how are the diners seated in the Jade Garden? You mentioned about the ventilation being proper. Well, what is the likelihood of more cases from Jade Garden? For the COVID development trend, currently is still on the upward trajectory. However, we're seeing the increase being on the decreasing speed. For the past 7 days, on average daily, there are about 1,826 cases. Compared for the last 7 days, on average there are about 1,264 cases. We see there's an increase of over 40% for the 7 days period. We anticipated with the holiday coming up and the public start to resume their normal lives, that the daily caseload or the community transmission will continue to rise. As for at what level will it peak is hard to estimate. It affected by several factors. For example, the overall social immunity, the vaccination status. With the fifth wave peaked on February and March, a lot of people were infected. And as time passes, and now with more than 3 months away, for those previously infected, if they did not get vaccinated, their immunity may wane over time, and this will entail the risk of reinfection. So different factors will affect how this wave will play out. In this current situation, even though our lives are getting back to normal, however, there's still a certain number of cases out there. Therefore, we suggest that the public should observe all the anti-epidemic measures and should get tested if they're showing any symptoms. For your second question on Jade Garden, well, so far we picked up, well, noticed three tables were infected involving five diners. Well, two of which remember where they were seated. We noticed they were not close to each other. Actually, they were quite far apart. Actually, maybe five or six tables away. And one table couldn't recall where they were seated. For the risk of outbreak, well, it occurred 10 days ago. Besides these few cases, so far, we haven't picked up any new cases. We'll monitor the Leave Home Safe records and their vaccine passes. I suppose that this outbreak has come to a close and no other staff has been infected. Next question, this lady. Cable news. For the New Life Association infected resident, may I know the gender and whether they are on the same floor? And how did it get infected? And for the sheltered workshop, any cases there? And how many workers in that workshop? For the Red Hill Peninsula case, what was the gender? And for the Jade Garden cluster, after analysis, do you see any connection with the Victoria Harbour restaurant? Thank you for your question. For the first question on the New Life Psychiatric Rehabilitation Association and hostel, the cases lived on the same floor but different rooms. These two live in the hostel and may have interacted with each other. And they both work in a sheltered workshop in Nam Chong operated by New Life, but on different floors. Well, acting out of caution, we recommend that the sheltered workshop should get all the staff tested by PCR. And so far through RIT, we couldn't pick up any cases. We believe that these two residents may have been infected and in their hostels on the halfway home. Well, the date of outbreak is 27-28. It's quite close to each other. We arranged their roommates to check into a quarantine facility. So far, the other staff or other residents, according to this morning RHA, they all tested negative. We'll continue to our epidemiological investigation. For the Jade Garden, we obtained some samples and we will perform a genomic analysis to see if they are consistent. For the BA.2.12.1, the different cases may have very similar genomic sequencing. However, that doesn't mean that for 100% they could be confirmed as related. In our investigation, we believe that the two clusters might have some linkages. For Victoria Restaurant, two cases on 19th of June. I went to another, have onset on 28th. When they visited that day, they may have a very small-scale outbreak of infection. Any other questions? Last two questions. The report in front. AM730. Last week, for the Sunrise diagnostic contamination, any update? For the Nina Hotel, what was the CT value? For the positive and negative sample, is it quite common? So you mentioned that she could be contaminated or infected in the corridor. Have you checked out the ventilation system? For the Victoria Harbour restaurant at the Belcher's was also on the compulsory testing declaration list. Which strain are we talking about? For the Victoria Harbour restaurant, for those who operated briefly, have you actually invoked 599H to order it to close? Or accepted the advisory from the FHD to close. For the Sunrise Diagnostics, I haven't have any update. We'll keep this in view. And for the Nina Hotel case, the sample was indeterminate by private labs. When it sent to the public health laboratory, and it came out positive. The CT value was quite high, over 30. The genomic sequencing we can confirm is L452L. We believe this is a BA.4 or BA.5. For this 27th of June, for another sampling, it tested negative. Two probabilities here. On maybe that case is not a recent infection case, maybe it'd been infection earlier and now probably at the end or actually recovered, or actually an early onset case. We will keep this in view. The ventilation system, since it's a quarantine hotel, before accepting guests, the CHP and the FHD and the EMSD staff had investigated this hotel and deemed fit for quarantine.
Last question about the vouchers. I don't have information at hand, but for restaurants subject to compulsory testing notices, usually it's due to new cases of these variants of Omicron, perhaps BA.2.12.1 and BA.4, BA.5. These cases visited the restaurant during the infectious period, and that is why the restaurants will be subject to CTNs. As for this case, I don't have information for the time being. Last question about Victoria Harbour Restaurant. Once the EMSD provides data to the FEHD, I understand that the FEHD has follow up on the case, and the restaurant already improved its ventilation system. I'm from Mingpao, about BA.4, BA.5 so far. How many imported cases of these two subvariants have entered the community? And recently, we've seen a surge in the number of imported cases involving hotels and the airport, and about the Poland Cork Daycare Center. How many elderly people have visited the center? And I understand that it's not subject to CTN. May I know the reason about Victoria Harbour Restaurant? Do you expect that the outbreak has come to an end? And about the air change rate, if it falls below 6, they will be required to install air purifiers. But if they don't switch on the air purifiers, does it mean that the rate still falls below standard and that could be outbreak? About a question for HA, more hospital beds were made available subject to the epidemic situation, but what are the criteria? Has it to do with patients' admission? For BA.4.5, the majority of cases logged at the moment are imported cases. Let me give you some figures. For BA.4, as of 2 days ago, we recorded 34 BA.4 and 64 BA.5. In the past 2 weeks, we've also identified some locally infected BA.4.5 cases, maybe a dozen of them, some of them related to imported cases. So for cases that have completed hotel quarantine, causing a transmission in the household after they've entered the community, we've only identified two cases. One is an elderly lady in Block 6 in Cornhill, and another in Patterson Street, Bagdak Dai Ha. And we've arranged for the family members to be quarantined as well. So far, we have not picked up any new related cases. As for the Poland Cork Day Center, yes, we identified one case. The case wears a mask and he works in the kitchen whilst working, and we have arranged for all staff members to get tested by PCR. And then we further identified one case who's also a kitchen worker. He wears a mask while working in the kitchen, but for prudence sake, we've arranged for other colleagues to be close contacts and be quarantined. These two workers, however, are not in contact with residents, or not so much residents, but elderly users of the daycare center. As there is no contact, the risk doesn't exist. Still, we'll keep in view the situation of this daycare center, and they've arranged for cleansing and disinfection as well. Regarding the requirement under CAP 599F, this is a stipulation provided by the FEHD in terms of the fresh air supply and air change per hour, and that there should be 6 exchanges. That is, even if there is a case in the premises, this will lower the risk of transmission. Of course, in terms of air purifiers, if they're not switched on, they may not meet the standard of 6 changes per hour. And I suppose the FEHD would conduct regular inspections, and that any non-compliance will be followed up on. While assessing the demand for hospital beds, we need to have certain backing. And according to Hong Kong Youth Projection, the peak of this wave may hit us in July or middle of July, and it is estimated that there would be 2,000 beds needed. So we have first-tier, second-tier beds together with the North Lantau Hospital. All in all, our supply should be able to cope. Now, why is it that we still have other plans such as 5,000, 10,000 beds made available within a period of time? This is subject to other uncertainties, including, for example, whether there are new subvariants and how much time has lapsed since the last wave. Because if we are quite far apart from the last wave, the immune level as a whole may drop and the number of infections may be on the rise. And that is why within a short period of time, we want to make sure more beds are available. Apart from the first tier, second tier beds and those in the Infections Control Center, we have also converted new beds to receive COVID patients, up to 10,000 of them. So we've made plans. For example, the beds in a certain facility would be made available within 48 hours, within a week or so. And we also have a real name rostering for manpower deployment. So whenever we commission more hospital beds in, say, hospitals in the North Lantau Hospital as well as AWE, each staff member would understand exactly where they are supposed to go. So if the case, well, we actually make available the hospital beds more than the Hong Kong U projections. That's the end of the press briefing.